today we are preparing to plant many seedlings we have, and basically we are preparing our own compost. Okay, we bought a lot of compost, but we are preparing our own mix of compost. So here we have a few examples of what we are purchasing, what we are buying. All right, so here, as you can see, the colors are different for all of these three types of compost. So of course the price brackets are different. This is the cheapest one you can get. This is also cheap, second cheapest, and this is a bit more expensive. The texture is very soft and crumbly, and you can feel that it's very fluffy. This one is a bit rough. As you can see, this is a wood-based compost, so it has a lot of carbon inside, however not that much nutrition, but it has also nutrition as well. But carbon in this type of soil will preserve moisture and will decompose over time, so this is a good start with. You don't need a full-fledged, already decomposed and very very soft compost. And together you can see vermiculite here, which is added for holding up moisture and dissolving minerals. However, this one here will help over time. So this is nothing for the first season. This will come into play in the second season. And this one, the third one, as you can see, is also a wood-based compost. However, also it holds a lot of moisture, but it has also nutrients as well. So they advertise here, they say that they have natural nutrients in there. At the same time, we are using, to amend the soil, we are using this. Wait a second, I'll put them in. So basically, these are bird droppings, which have been matured and then dried out. So there is a whole process where they do that, and we're also using for roots and seeds, we're using mycorrhizae fungi, and this is only a little bit when we transplant the plants. We mix the compost. Now it's a more homogeneous mixture. Now after we mix the soil, this is what we have for our raised tops. I would say it's like, we don't like to use pots because majority of pots they don't have the ability to mimic natural processes of the soil and how the soil composition works. So basically, if you have a clay top or a clay pot, or if you have a plastic pot, it will not allow for the air to breathe on all sides. So we found this nifty thing, and these are garden collection pop-up bags. So these are made from some kind of woven polyurethane, and they are breathable as well. We are making some holes into them. So this is how they look. They're cheap. They're like between 6 euros to 10 euros, depending where you buy them. These are from Lidl. I think Lidl is widely available in Europe. And what we do with them is like, we put about 25 centimeters of soil inside, and then we kind of put them down and tie them. But yeah, we'll do one now. The fabric is not watertight, but we prefer to put a bit more holes inside, just because when you have too much rain, we don't want to keep too much moisture in there, so the excess will be able to go out. So this is what we're doing at the bottom. We are doing every 5 to 6 centimeters on around of the bag. So what we are doing, we are using wood chips at the bottom, because if it's a little bit more moisture, we don't want for the roots to You don't want for the roots to be too in water. And this is kind of the same as any raised bed which people would do. So, okay, this is the best example. This is the best example how to, okay, it's the other way around. But in general, if you want to do a raised bed, at the bottom you have wood chip and the carbon layer, and then you here have the compost layer. So this is, we are trying to mimic the same process. And this is a standardized process. It's nothing we invented or something this company who produced these wood chips invented. And with the raised beds and with tops, you usually want to have at the bottom a layer where moisture cannot build up and cannot promote anaerobic life. So we want aerobic with life with oxygen, and we don't want to promote life without oxygen. Okay, so I have a bit more. I need to put a bit more wood chips here. Just 2 centimeters. I would say 2 centimeters is enough. So after the wood chips, we'll just start putting soil on top. And after each 5 centimeter layer, you would want to pat it down so it's a bit more compact. As you can see, this is type of a springy bag, so it has a spring in here which always raises it on top. So we don't want to have 60-70 centimeter raised bed. In this way, what we are doing is we take some wire. You can use anything else, it doesn't matter. So what we are doing, we are taking wire and we are making it so it stays in one spot, so it doesn't go up. Okay, so now we have a top. Here we can plant, and then we'll put a little bit of wood chips on the top, and then we water everything down. Reporting more peppers. We went to the shop the other day, and we saw a bunch of varieties in there which we didn't have seeded at home. So these are like two types of paprikas, one red one which we already have, and this is orange yellowish. Now we are repotting them in the new beds which we built. They are already soaked in water. So what I'm doing is I take it like this and shake it a little bit. And as you can see, the difference between a plastic pot, which doesn't allow to breathe, the roots continuously grow. They don't stop growing. You see how the roots are like circling around the plastic pot. However, in this type of thing, in this type of pots, where you have aeration, or in the ground, where if the roots end up to a lot of oxygen or light, they will not grow anymore. So the plant will not continuously grow roots. However, in this situation is okay because the root structure is very good. So now we are making sure that we have a good structure here. Okay, so let's see if it works. Okay, it works. And what I'm doing, I will put some mycorrhizae fungi here, and I think some of it in the hole. Mycorrhizae fungi, it's a species of fungi which evolved a pretty good symbiosis with plants. Basically, the fungi will search for the nutrients in the soil, and the plant will provide fungi all of the sugars necessary, because fungi cannot process their own sugars, right? So, and this is quite old symbiosis being done, and a lot of people don't know about this, because it's not being taught in school or anything like that. Only if you are investigating a little bit, then you'll find out exactly how it works. And a lot of people who use chemicals and pesticides and other non-organic components, they will basically destroy the soil food web. And we try to provide more soil food web, microbes, protozoa, and other types of microbiological life, including fungi. Fungi is an integral part of the soil. So we are trying to promote growth without using chemicals which are not natural to the soil. Okay, so now we have some cucumbers. We have a few varieties. So we like the smaller variety of cucumbers, mostly because of the taste, and mostly because we are used to this type of variety of cucumbers in Eastern Europe. We do like them a lot. So here we have basically two types of zucchinis. It is one yellow and one green. However, we'll see how it goes. And the same thing, you see it in a pot, the roots are continuously growing. They are not stopping to grow, so they need a lot of water.